Hi everyone, and welcome to a Mighty Ginkgo tutorial. My name is Zero, and I'll be your instructor today. Let me see if I can clear this up. Now, I may sound terrible, and that's because I am right now. But I am so full of creative energy that I can't sleep. And you got a cold, and you can't sleep, and I keep having nightmares that I finish the tutorial, and I wake up, and I'm like, yeah, I'm done! And then it's like, oh crap, that was just a dream. So, I am going to hack and cough my way through this tutorial so I can finally let that Mucinex do its job. So, in this lesson, I'm going to show you how to make MMd dances come into Second Life. Now, it is quite a process that you'll need to do, and there are a lot of limitations to this program. When it does work, it is the most awesomest thing ever, because all you have to do is download and then run some command code, and there, you have it, your MMd dance. Now, I'm going to say right now, I don't really know how to convert these into bento dances. I had the theory where when they go into the Second Life format, like the BVH, go from VMD to BMH, we can run it through Avastar's animation translator. I tried that before, and every time I do, none of the motions all the way transfer over. So once I get enough energy, I'm going to have to do some research on how do you transfer animations from one rig to another without using Avastar. Maybe there's a Blender method, because the Avastar thing is calling on some command, so it has to be inside a Blender somewhere. I have to thank Iron Man for this help, because without him, well, I did this before on my old computer, but I totally forgot how to set it up, and he's like super good with code, so I was like, can you help me with this? And then he just sent me the instruction manual in English that I'm going to show you how to use. So yeah, thanks Iron Man a lot for this. We can finally do the tutorial. You can stop glaring at me from the side, because I know you're doing it. Okay. So before we begin, let's talk about the limitations and what to really expect from this. First of all, you're going to need Windows 7. They said that it may work on Windows 8, and when I had asked a friend of mine to test it out on their computer, they said it didn't work because they had Windows 10. Although I'm not 100% sure that's still accurate to today, but the last time we tried this out, it didn't work for him. So Windows 10 users, you gotta, you know, kind of go into this expecting it to fail. It doesn't work on the Mac, from what I understand. This is strictly a Windows thing. You will also need a PMD model dancer. You can't use PMX models at all with this method. It just fails. But you could probably convert your PMX into a PMD. I'm not too MMD savvy to know how to do that. But if you can, then it's great. So essentially what it does is it takes the model and it takes the dance and then it converts it into a BVH. Then we go and put it into another program that converts that BVH into Second Life BVH files. And only difference between that is it renames all the bones to Second Life bones, and it, come on, Brandon, you know what else it does. It chops them down into uploadable parts, because you can only upload an animation that's 59.9 seconds in Second Life. It doesn't matter how many frames it is, as long as it's 59.9 seconds. 60 seconds is the max, but, you know, if you're just over by a millisecond of time, it'll fail. So the program chops it up at 59.9 just to give you that buffer of one, and it does it all for you. So that's why it's like a lot of work, but it's still good. Yeah, I guess the rest of the stuff we can do it when we when we get to it. All right, so let's begin our tutorial and start working.